I mean, oh yeah, sure. I thought about it. I thought about killing myself a few times. I love coffee way too much to die. Have you ever just waited outside someone's house until they got home so you can go in there and murder them, you know? Thank you for tuning in to another episode of Darth News. I'm your host, Darth. Today we'll be talking about Iran. Like, I ran a mile, bitch. What did you do today? You know, I love how the left is just freaking out over Iran. It's Iran, by the way, not Iran. And I know this because I'm Iranian. Okay, there's a little hint. A little wink wink. It's to my heritage. That's right, motherfucker. I'm Iranian. Well, half Iranian. But still, I speak Farsi.
عزیزم جونم بیا 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 اینجا بیشین بیشین بالا آخه 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 خیلی قشنگه ماشالله بزرگ شد
You are so strong
What? You are so beautiful Why you not model? Why you not a model or actor? Did your baba tell you to become doctor? Did your baba tell you to become lawyer? Yeah
Seriously I am part Half, I'm half. Half sand nigger, god damn it. My blood is full of sand, and so is my vagina. It is kind of annoying that everybody all over all the media channels, all the news channels, except for Fox News, like literally everyone except for Fox, all of them, they're all just saying World War III, oh, the plane getting shot down by the Iranian government is Trump's fault. This kind of rhetoric needs to stop. It's toxic, and it's not okay. Not okay. It was absolutely a warranted execution, motherfucker. Assassination. It was an assassination. But it was a lawful assassination, which took place in Iraq. Now, Trump has full military authority in Iraq, meaning he was well within his rights to attack this known terrorist. Not just a terrorist, the worst terrorist on the face of this earth right now. There's more blood on Soleimani's hands than any other person living today. So to hear the left just freak out and defend this sadistic dictator is infuriating. It's so infuriating. I just can't. Tina, shut up. Just shut up. I'm having a moment. No, I don't want any marshmallows. Okay, well, maybe marshmallows sound good. All right, I'll have a marshmallow. It's like the left can't give Trump one good day. When we killed, what's his name? Al-Baghdadi, the ISIS leader. The left was like, oh my God, this was so sad. Fucking minds, are you out of your minds? Like, the Trump derangement syndrome has gotten so bad that the left is now defending terrorism. What the fuck? It's like, what? These crony Democrats and elitists and the corporate Democrats, they've always wanted war. It's profitable. They've always supported it. When Trump decided not to attack Iran because Iran shot down a couple of our fucking drones, when he decided not to attack them, because there was no loss of human life, they lost their minds. Now, when Americans actually die at the U.S. Embassy, when Iran attacks U.S. Embassy, which is inherently U.S. sovereign soil, we freak out? What the fuck? I can't do this. I just can't. And it's like for 3 days straight, CNN just played nothing but the rally, the protest with all the ayatollahs and the mullahs for the Khomeini, all the fucking radical Islamics. They're just playing nonstop, repeat protests of radical Muslim Islamic people, and it's a very small percentage. But they're not showing all of the protests that are happy that Soleimani is dead. From Turkey all the way from Istanbul down through Iran to Iraq, everyone's celebrating, cheering in the streets. Universities in Iran are erupting in protest. They're laying down the American and Israeli flags, and they're walking around them. They're not even stepping on these American flags. You have Iranian students graffitiing the walls all over in Farsi which translates to "Well done, Trump." Everybody is happy that Soleimani is dead, but the media in the United States and maybe even the UK want to show you one small percentage of what's happening, because that one little smidgen of a percentage is what relates to their narrative. If it doesn't fit their fucking narrative, then they just don't give a fuck. They'll lie to you. So that's what they do. They lie and lie and lie, and they're lying to you every day. And of course, Fox News is not, you know, innocent in all of this. I mean, but at least Fox News, yes, it has a bias, for sure. It does. It's definitely biased. But it just spits the facts. It doesn't put a twist on it to fit a narrative. It just tells you what's up. And like, that's exactly what people need to hear, is what's up. Not your opinion, not your emotional opinion on it. That's not journalism. That's journalism. That's bullshit. Look, I really am Iranian, and I have family in Iran, and we're on WhatsApp, and we're talking back and forth, and they are thrilled to death that this happened. That this happened. And they're actually kind of weirdly happy that Iran, the Ayatollah, shot down the Ukraine plane carrying 36 Canadians and 130 Iranians on board. They're actually happy that Iran did that. They're not happy. Okay, they're not happy that happened. Okay, but they are happy that now they have a reason for an uprising. And I mean like a real uprising. They could truly transform and uproot this regime, this corrupt regime. And if they can successfully do this somehow, I mean, maybe they can be part of the world in a functional way. The people of Iran want to be part of this world. They love America. Oh, you're from America. I love you. You're so handsome. I love that you're from America. I love America. I want to go to Los Angeles. Like, Trump does not want to go to war. And he said it 1,000 times. What he did was an act of force. Not just a force of military, but because he was forced to react. Trump drew a line and he said, look, this is my red line. If you kill any Americans, you're fucked. So what does Soleimani do? He organized and orchestrated an attack on the U.S. Embassy in Iraq and killed Americans. So Trump said, push a button, ka-boom, you're done. You're done, son. If Trump didn't react with military force, which by the way was surgical, it was fucking so goddamn precise. He there was no other casualties, just this motherfucker and whoever was in his car. Wah, boom! But if Trump didn't attack, what that would do is send a message. It would send a message to Iran and the Ayatollahs and the regime that we can be stepped on. It would just send a message to them. It would send a message to everybody in the world. Trump didn't strike because he wanted to stay there for oil or for whatever. There's no reason for us to attack Iran. He attacked because they attacked first. And then Iran retaliates with this bullshit, just zoop. They have these, I mean, precise missile launching systems that don't miss targets, but they missed. They missed on purpose because Iran knew that if we actually blew up Americans, it would be fucking dunzo. It would be dunzo. You follow? Iran would be a fucking parking lot. And I died when Trump flexed the 52 new fighter jets that just came out, because Iran has 52 military bases all throughout the country. And Trump's like, yeah, I got 52 of these bitches ready for your ass. So now, yeah, I'm not a huge fan of Trump, okay? I like Trump. He's grown on me. Don't hate me. Please don't hate me. But do I actually look like I could be a Hillary supporter? Come on. Do you really think, with my humor, I'm a Hillary or a fucking Bernie supporter? For Christ's sake! Get a grip. I'm clearly offensive, and so is D. Trump, all right? So we kind of relate a little bit. Basically, if anyone actually is upset about the attack that happened in Iran. It's like Trump is not responsible for Iran shooting down that fucking plane. He's not. First of all, Iran isn't even saying that it's America's fault. Iran just owned up and was like, yep, we kind of fucked up. We shot him down. What do you want? So Iran at least admits to it, but they don't say anything about how it's America's fault. They don't point the blame anywhere. But the Democrats here in America have no problem pointing the blame to Trump. It's Trump's fault. What, are you kidding me? The airlines shouldn't have had any commercial airlines flying through a fucking active war zone anyway. So for just anyone who thinks that what Trump did was wrong, I gotta tell you, sorry, you're wrong. You, not me. You're wrong. You've been drinking too much soy. You've been watching too much CNN. Do you get it? The only cure is to switch to any other news channel besides MSNBC, but any other one, and stop drinking soy. Whew, okay, sorry. I had to vent because I'm Persian. I'm Persian, and it's been a little while since I vented. I probably vented like 20 minutes ago, but I needed to vent. Point of video, Iran is actually thrilled. Someone just drove by and they were like, what? Iran is thrilled that we killed Soleimani. Now sure there's gonna be a replacement for Soleimani. Salam alaikum. Allah Akbar. Sure, maybe somebody will step up as Soleimani, but the point is, it's going to take six of the greatest known terrorists to make one Soleimani, so we did a good thing. That's it. That's all I got for you. That's all I have. Thank you for tuning in to another episode of Darth News. I'm your host, Darth. Until next time, don't forget to pull out. Like O-O-L-P-O, pull, like a swimming pool. Oh, yes, like, share, subscribe. Subscribe! Subscribe! Then we take it what you got, bro.